to the 12 lost tribes of the nation of Israel who are scattered abroad. Greetings on the open forum this evening. So shalom, my brothers. Thank you for tuning in this evening to hear the word of Yahweh Shemar Shah for your spiritual edification and put on your armor for the day of salvation. So last time we was on the air, we're doing a series of the African-American movement, part two. This is part two of the African-American movement. And we're going to go into the scriptures this evening and show you things about the law that the Most High warned us about. So let's go to our opening scripture this evening, brothers. Shalom out to all the brothers tuning in. Let's go to our opening scripture this evening. Let's go to Ecclesiasticus and the Apocrypha, chapter 19. Let's go to Ecclesiasticus chapter 19 and the Apocrypha, verse 19. This is what Yahweh says in the Bible. The knowledge of the commandments. Y'all hear that? He didn't say the knowledge of the people. The knowledge of a church. The knowledge of an institution. No, he didn't say that. Yahweh said, the knowledge of the commandments of Yahweh is the doctrine of life. I want y'all to meditate on that. Life, as we see it now, is not the life that Yahweh wanted us to live. Do y'all understand that, brothers? Where Israel is right now, in North Central South America, the islands of the sea, from Judah down to Issachar, the life that we are living now is not toward the Most High Yahweh. It's toward whoredoms, ignorance, degeneration, sin, and abominations. And this is why the Most High is calling us back to life. To give us the laws of life and the Son, Yahweh Shah, for the faith. Because remember, the laws of Moses was the knowledge of sin. Now we are righteous through what? The belief in Yahweh Shah, the great one. So the Most High warned our people in the commandments of life not to do certain things. And this is why people are not obtaining it. See what he says here? And they that do these things that please him shall receive the fruit of the tree of immortality. Now, Shasha told us that in the Bible. He told that young man, he said, you want to inherit eternal life? He said, keep the commandments. That's what we teach here at the base. You want to be acceptable again to the Most High people? We must come through the straight gate and keep commandments and the faith of the Most High Son. Then he said, we shall have life abundantly. And this is what our people don't have right now. What we have now is my life, hell. And let's see the warnings of the commandments of life that the Most High warned us about. Let's everybody go to your King James Version Bible this evening. Let's go to the book of Leviticus, the books of the law. This is the doctrine of life right here. Let's go to Leviticus 17:7. This is what Yahweh told our people to be careful of and to watch out for and not to do and to be diligent and not doing these things. And we failed it. So let's go to Leviticus 17:7. Did not Yahweh warn us? This is what he said. He said, and they shall no more offer their sacrifices unto doves, after whom they have gone a hunt. This shall be a statute forever unto them throughout their generations. See that? So throughout the generations, Jehovah warned our people in the laws of Moses, through the prophets, in this day and time now, as we come to you live on this program. Keep commandments, and you'll be walking in the doctrine of life. Keep Mashasha as the chief cornerstone of our congregation, and we receive eternal life. So the people were warned about these devils. We were warned in the law not to worship other powers. And today we're going to show you one of them in the so-called African-American movement called Kwanzaa. What the hell is that, man? Sound like a ricochet off a rock or something. And here you go. Let's go to Deuteronomy 6:13. Stay in the law and the testimony when you're teaching the people out there. Don't say what they want you to say. You say what the law says. Let's go to Deuteronomy 6 and start at verse 13. Jehovah says this about his law and his order. Thou shalt fear the Lord your power. Y'all hear that? The fear of the Most High is the beginning of wisdom for the Israelites. A lot of people don't fear the Most High. They're not been taught fear of the Most High. What they've been taught? The precepts of men. Christmas, New Year's, Halloween. Kwanzaa. And we're going to find out about these hoarders. See what it says here? Verse 14. You shall not go after other gods or the gods of the people that are round about you. You hear that? What's around us today? Catholics. Baptists. Muslims. Atheists. Effeminate. You name it. We're in the midst of it, people. But Yahweh told us when we gather, stay away from these doctrines of devils. If you're a stray dog from the pack, what happens to you when another dog touches you? They destroy your butt, don't they? This is why the Lord told us in the book of Hebrews, some of us have neglected the assembling of the people. Don't neglect the assembly of the people, brother, of the righteous, of the elect of Israel. Come through that straight gate and stay under the wings of Yahweh, according to Psalms 91. This is how you're going to make it out of here. Verse 15. For the Lord your power, Yahweh, is a jealous power. Wait a minute. I thought the Lord ain't got no emotions. He's all love. The Bible says the Most High Yahweh is a jealous power. Meaning what? If you go worship another god, Israel, or sacrifice to another devil, Yahweh is jealous of that. And there will be repercussions for what we do. See? That's the anger. There you go right there. Of the Lord your power be kindled against thee, and destroy thee from off the face of the earth. Were we not destroyed from Jerusalem and our name off the face of the earth? That's why we know today as so-called Negroes, West Indians, Puerto Ricans, Haitians, Dominicans. Our names are mud. That's not who we are. Now we got Kwanzaa, invented by somebody amongst our people. We're going to show you that this evening. See what it says here? You should not tempt the Lord your power as you tempted them and myself. So when you go back in the scriptures, you'll see the Most High constantly told Israel, don't do this, don't do that, don't tempt me. Don't play with them. He gave you straight commandments, learn them, do them, and keep them if you want eternal life. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 6. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 6. We deal with the law tonight. The laws of life. It is written. Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 6. I am Vayalaya. When you go back to the last one, Kodash. The Lord your power. It may say Allah. It may say Yahweh there in ancient Hebrew. Which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. From the house of bondage. Y'all remember Egypt? We were not from Egypt. For 430 years we sojourned in that area. And our people came out of there under Moses. Met the Most High on Mount Sinai. And the mountain quaked. And Yahweh came down in the mothership. And he spake to the people. When he spake to our people back then, the whole assembly of the 12 tribes was around that mountain. And they ran. They went to Moses. They said, look, Moses, please. Please, Moses. They said, don't let the Most High speak to us anymore. We want to hear what you got to say. You know why? Because the Most High is power. He's energy. He's spirit. He's not like us. When you read in Revelations, when he said John went up through that door and went into a peak of heaven, he saw the Most High sitting on his throne, the color of amber. What's the color of amber, people? Dark. Like a sardis stone. And he said around about the throne, he saw a rainbow. And he saw a man sitting upon it. And this figure that he saw, that John the Revelator was able to go and see that through human eyes, through a vision, he saw the Ancient of Days sitting upon his throne. That's who y'all supposed to be fearing, people. That's why when I come on the air, it's all about the business of the Most High. I become another man. Speaker. Teacher. Exhortation. To fear him. And around his throne, he had 24 elders and four beasts before him. And an entourage of heavenly angels calling out his name every day. Glory, glory. Hallelujah to the highest. And you say it ain't no power? You better get on your knees and repent. Because there is one in the heavens. You just can't see him because he's in another dimension beyond this earth. You better get into these scriptures. Then you'll see what the Most High is about. See what he says here? What did he say here? Deuteronomy 5, verse 6. From the house of bondage, thou shalt have no other powers before me. You hear what the Most High said? Don't turn from Yahweh's commandments. Don't turn from the teachings of Yahweh Shah. Don't turn from the books of the law and the testimony of the King James Version Bible. Right here. See this here? Talking about Black History Month. Black History Month does not exist in the eyes of the Israelites. Because in our eyes, only the law and the testimony exists in the records of the Bible. And wisdom of the Most High is here. But we don't acknowledge what our foolish people do. Because they have no knowledge. Hosea 4 and 6 to destroy. See what it says here? Thou shalt not make unto you any graven image, or any likeness of anything that's in the heaven above, or that's in the earth beneath, or that's in the water beneath the earth. Thou shalt not bow thyself unto them. Do not bow to any other power except Yahweh. Nor serve them. For I, the Lord Yahweh, am a jealous power, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, upon the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. Why you think we caught hell? Why you think we here? Some of our forefathers from generations ago did not keep these commandments. And it fell on all of us that's here tonight. But by the grace of the Most High, Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, he called us unto mercy. Isaiah 14, the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and yet choose Israel, right? That's why we're here tonight, to get edified. Let's go to Psalms 107 verse 11. This is what our people's problem is. Psalms 107, start at verse 11. This is where we are right now, people. All these groups, all this back to Africa, all the Seventh-day Adventists and Muslims, Christmas, New Year's, Kwanzaa, is what? Here you go right here. Psalms 107, verse 11, it says what? Because they rebelled against the words of Yahweh, our people are rebellious. You're a bunch of rebels, man. What did Yahweh teach us in the Bible? Don't have no other power beyond Yahweh. Don't change his name to nothing else except what is written in the records. Learn the Hebrew. Call upon the Most High with a pure heart. Learn of Yahweh Shah's name. Yahweh Shah, Allah Yahshah, Mahashah, Mahashah, Yahweh Shah. All these make reference to the anointed Savior. Keep the commandments brings us back to Mashasha. Many of us have not learned Mashasha. So he said, right now this nation is in what? In verse 11, because they rebelled against the words of Yahweh and contempt the counsel of the Most High. Don't you know our people are in contempt right now? All these groups we got out here. Kwanzaa. Black Power, Fagots, Communists, Malcolm X, Christian Church, Muslim, Back to Africa, Black Flag, Red, Black and Green, Red, Black and Green, was made up by civil rights activists. This is not what Yahweh gave us to present in holiness and Kodash. This is man-made. And this is why our people, leaders, as we said last time, caused us to what? To err. Isaiah 59 says, your sins have held good things from us that he will not hear. The first thing is acceptance. The second is repentance. The third is submitting. This is what Yahweh wants us to do, to come back to him. Because this is what we were supposed to be in the first place. Get used to it. See what he says? Therefore he brought them down, and their heart will labor. You know what they do? What the Negroes do every September? Y'all ever seen this before? Now tell me this ain't the Most High's power in this time. Y'all go out there on Eastern Parkway, y'all want to see a spectacle? Go up there and see our people what it just said right here in the Bible. That's how we know we the Israelites. He put you down in labor. Don't you know our foolish people celebrate? Look at this sister here. What a whore. Plus, spittle. The Lord said a whore is a spit. A faggot is an abomination. A lesbian is an abomination. That's what we look at when we see things like this. The Negro sees a flag with colors on it talking about what? Everybody get down with everything. No, hell no. We stand in the council of the Most High because the people done contempted the Most High in their council. Look at this. This is a Labor Day parade. Look at this woman bent over like a prostitute in the street. Go up there on Eastern Parkway. Get your ticket, get your hotel on Eastern Parkway in Brooklyn. Go up there and see the Labor Day parade. You want to see a spectacle of labor? These Negroes are homeborn slaves. They up there riding around on a damn pole. Look at this woman. Butt naked in the street. Look at our sisters. This ain't Israelite attire. The women ain't got their heads wrapped. The sisters ain't got their dresses on. So what the hell is this? I'm going to show you what it is. The people are in what? In contempt, right? Let's show you what Yahweh said this is. Go to Isaiah chapter 3. He brought them down with labor. Don't you know these foolish Negroes celebrate Labor Day? Labor Day was set up by the white man, his festivals, when he brought them in slavery. The slaves used to be in huts, and they would go out there down in the Caribbean and see the masters dancing in the street with whoredoms. So the Negroes decided, we want to do it too. And they brought this stuff to the Americas. And now look at our people now. Look at this. Look at this brother here. What kind of Negro is it? What the hell is he into? Satan. That's all it is. It's the damn devil. Our brothers and sisters don't went. Look at these brothers up there all painted up like this. Blowing horns. Remember old stupid Junith? That day Junith, that's another day of boredom for our people. The white man had us go, so we didn't get the emancipation information until June 9th. And we take that and turn it into a culture. We take ignorance and turn it into a culture. That's not our heritage, people. Just like we told you last time on the air, black is not a heritage. It's a color. And the meanings of it is dirty, unenlightened, ignorant, evil. And this is what we hold on to as truth. What the Lord told us in Isaiah. Chapter 3, verse 8. Listen to this. For Jerusalem is ruined. You know what's wrong with our people? You're destroyed by like an adage. You're trodden down by the nations. The Most High kicked us out of Jerusalem because we didn't keep commandments. And we're ruined right now. And Judah is fallen. Judah was the head tribe of all the tribes. They were the leaders. That's why we caught it more than anybody. And all the other tribes caught it too. So the whole nation collapsed. Like a bunch of dominoes, 12 dominoes, and they fell over. See? Because their tongue and their doings are against the Most High. See, we went against our Maker. And what do we go against? His commandments. Right now we are in contempt. Meaning what? Go to the white man's court and you run a damn red light. Or you get caught drunk driving down the street and you don't show up in court. What happens to you? They put a warrant out for your arrest, don't they? You got a warrant out for 12 tribes, according to the Bible. And we are searching for you to bring you back to your Maker so you can get out of prison. And that's our job as disciples. Matthew 10, 5, and 6. And if you don't listen to the counsel of the Most High, it's on you. See? So he said, what? Because their tongue and their doings are against the Yahweh, to provoke his eyes on the globe. The show of their countenance does witness against them. Look at this. What were we just saying about the contempt. And they declare their sin as Sodom, they hide it not. This is like Sodom and Gomorrah. You see this? This is one of the whoredoms of our people. That so-called Labor Day parade. This thing is satanic. It's harsh. You go up there, people get shot. You got thousands of cops up there watching these foolish Negroes with demons on them every so-called September. You don't get paid right. You ain't got the right education, and you got the nerve to celebrate that damn Labor Day. That Labor Day is pagan. And this is what our people are right now. That's what the Lord said. And the countenance of them and the way we look and conduct ourselves is as the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah, people. This is what Israel is right now. Let's go back to Psalms 107, verse 11, and moving on from there. So we're in contempt of the Most High's walls. See what it says? He brought them down, their hearts were labor, and they fell down, and there was none to what? To help. Your government ain't helping you. United States can't help you. Let's go there and show you that. We constantly go to this government that cannot save us. We run to them and we cry to them. And they can't save our people. And we constantly do it. Let's go to Lamentations, people. Lamentations of Jeremiah. Jeremiah was crying. He said, Lord, he said, Father, look at the people. He said, they're going to be in this captivity. He was crying. He said, they're going to be catching hell. Here, go right here. Lamentations 4:17. As for us, our eyes are yet failed, for our vain help and our watching will watch for a nation that could not save us. Take this government over us right now. Who's over us right now? The United Snakes. Hell, they can't even govern their damn selves. Nevertheless, give you liberty, justice, fall. So Yahweh told us that. And here we are right now in contempt of this body. Our people are. You see what he says here? Psalms 107. Verse 13. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. This is what Yahweh wants us to do in this time. Cry out. Pray. Repent. Then he'll hear you if you acknowledge the truth. It says here, he brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death and break their bands asunder. That's what we're looking for. Freedom. And we're going to get it in the day of salvation according to this Bible from Yahweh. You ain't free in this country. You men are slaves. See what it says here? All that men would praise Lamanatazathah. That's what praise means, Yahweh. For his goodness and for his wonderful works for the children of men. For us, Israel, that's what we need. We need that in this damn time. Because right now, our people are in contempt of the laws of the Most High. We don't celebrate the right things. We don't come up for the services. Why? Because our people left the laws. And what are they doing out here? Let's go show you what he told us to do and what we ain't doing. Let's go to Psalms 81 verse 1. It says this, thus saith the Lord Yahweh. Sing aloud unto the high our strength, and make a joyful noise unto the power of Jacob. Take a psalm and bring hither the trumpet and a pleasant harp and a psaltery. Blow out the trumpet and the new moon and the time appointed on our solemn feast days. This is what we were supposed to do, people. In this land, we're supposed to rehearse the righteous acts. There's nowhere in the Bible the Lord told us to celebrate no Kwanzaa. It's not in here. This is what he told us to do in the law. Rehearsing the Shabbat days, the feast days, the memorials. We're supposed to be celebrating Halloween, Passover, Parom, and the month of Adar, Tabernacles, Feast of Unleavened Bread, the Gagaka, the dedication, year round. This goes year round, people. You got to show up for this, and these memorials and these statues, in order for you to get blessings during the year and protection from the Most High. See that? For this was a statue for Israel. No, it was a statue for the world. God so loved the world. No. He said, for this in verse 4, Psalms 81, verse 4, was a statue for Israel and a law of the power of Jacob. This is why our people are not receiving any blessings from Yahweh. You go on to church on Sunday, you go to a Kwanzaa, and we're going to show you tonight where that came from. For the power of Jacob, this is what the Most High gave us. In Leviticus chapter 23, he gave you the whole list of the Kodash Yahweh. And he said that, thus saith the Lord, O house of Israel, these are my feast days. These are the days that I recognize. He made some low and some high. Let's read that. Let's go to Ecclesiastes chapter 33, verse 7. This is what he said in the Bible. It says this. Why does one day excel another, when there's all the light of every day and year of the sun? So y'all might ask, why do we have to keep feast days? Why? Aren't all days the same? No, they're not, according to Yahweh. By the knowledge of Yahweh, they were distinguished. You hear that? That's why the Shabbat is distinguished, the rehearsal. That's why the Feast of Dedication is rehearsed. That's why the Halloween, Passover, when it come in, we go by the new moons and the days appointed, according to Psalms 81. See? And he altered the seasons, and some of them has he made high days and hallowed them, and some has he made to be made ordinary days. This is the work of Yahweh. He ordained this for us. So when the Shabbat come in, where are you supposed to be at on the Shabbat? In the congregation, in the assembly of the elect of Israel, coming to get your edification, coming to worship and reverence and show respect. This is how you get blessings. Then the moral laws, civil laws, dietary laws have to be kept. Do you eat pork? Do you eat shrimp? Do you eat lobster? Crab? Do you go to bed with white money? Huh? You go to bed with a white man? Mm-hmm. Michael Strahan? And all the rest of you old, I call you colonial Negroes out there. You're colonial Negroes now. Y'all love these white women. Every time you see a Negro now, he got a white woman on his arm. Or the black woman got a white man on her arms. This is an abomination. Race makes it. Men going to bed with men. Faggot flags. Chinese man with the black woman. And the black man with the Chinese woman. All of this is all up, as we said last time. And this is what our people are doing out here. And we have to tell y'all this. Like we're telling you about the feast days. And the high holy days in Leviticus chapter 23. He made it and distinguished it in the law. So you'll come up and he said, these are my days that I acknowledge, Israel. Now, let's go to the book of what? The 10th verse of Psalms 81, verse 10. What is Israel's problem? This is a problem with the whole nation. What did we do? He said this. I am Yahweh thy power, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Open thy mouth wide, and I will fill it. So tonight you're going to get filled with knowledge. But my people would not hearken to my voice. Y'all hear that? This is what Israel's problem is. You don't listen. You don't do. You don't abide. When the prophets come to you, you avoid us. You say, I ain't going to do that. See? No, we won't walk in it. Then you're going to die. And Israel was none of me. So you have to want to deal with the Most High and have a relationship with him. Paul and them said, you must have a willing mind to come up to the Shabbat, to the Passover. Put on your garments. Put your life on the line for Yahweh Shah. You must be willing. If you're not willing, brothers and sisters, we're not going to run behind you and hold your hand. We're going to stand there with you and support you and the weak and the sick. But if you don't want to be here, it's going to show. And believe me, over the years, I've seen brothers and sisters that don't want to. We tell y'all to take dreads out your damn hair so the Most High won't strike your ass down. And you know what you tell us? I'm going over there with brother such and so, and he ain't going to say nothing to me. Well, you go ahead with the sinners then. The sinners going to go along with you. We going along with the Lord. Open the truth is better than secret love. See? And he says what? So I gave them up into their own heart's lust. You know what's wrong with our people? You got lustful hearts. And they walk in their own counsels. You know what the counsel of the Negro is today? Let's go to Romans chapter 10, verse 1. Paul said it, and I said it too. Go to Romans chapter 10, verse 1. He said this, brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to Yahweh for Israel is that they might be saved. You hear that? Mm-hmm. He didn't say everybody in Israel was going to be saved. He said that some of y'all might be saved because of the way we conduct ourselves as a nation. For I bear on record that they have a zeal of the Lord. You see them brothers out there on the street wearing baseball caps? They wannabes. I saw the Israelite brothers years ago, man, and I want to be one of them. And you still walking around here with baseball caps on, wearing sneakers. You running around here talking about you got a white woman on your arms, you got a garment on, and you got Miss Ann on your arm. That's unlawful. You a hypocrite, man. When you put this on, that means you put it on with discipline. Mm-hmm. Well, I want to be with you. I can't get with you, woman, because you are Edomite. I want to be with you. You're a Moabite. I want to be with you, brother. I'm going to knock your teeth down your throat, brother. You're a faggot. See, that's how you got to be as a man. You got to have your guard on and your armor on. Because these damn evil demons out here are going to come at you, brothers. Sisters, if a man don't want to marry you according to the law, leave that broke banana dick Negro alone. Because you're supposed to be getting married. You're a princess. And you got a lot of brothers in the camp, jive-ass Negroes, and call your asses out, too. Going to bed with our princes that are of the power, and you're not marrying them. This has to stop. And it's going to stop with the counsel of the Most High. Because if you don't stop doing it, you're a fornicator, and all fornicators ain't getting in the kingdom. You're going to be left behind. Repent, brothers and sisters. So he said, they have a zeal of the power, but not according to knowledge. For they being ignorant of Yahweh's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of the Most High. That's why I tell all you brothers that I reach on this internet service worldwide, brothers, we reach in the supermarket, those of you who's working in Kmart, those of you just walking down the street, those that we call out to, we tell y'all, come in and submit yourself to this knowledge. It's about submitting, brothers and sisters. If you ain't able to submit to the Most High's will, you are not acceptable to him. That's what's wrong with our people. So now we understand where these Negroes are at right now. Now we understand that our people got what? They got their own thing going on out here. And right now, the Israelites worldwide have changed this knowledge of the Most High. Let's go to Jeremiah 17. I'm going to show you some of these groups that's out here. I'm showing you one of the main ones I'm talking about tonight, the so-called Kwanzaa rites. The sin of Judah is written with a pen of iron, with a point of a diamond. It's right here in the Bible. Deuteronomy 28 is on all of us. It's graven upon the table of your heart and upon the horns of your altars. All your damn churches, and we're telling you about all these groups, it's written on them. That's why we know it's you. By the word of Yahweh. It's on you. Scripture upon scripture, line upon line. You can't run and hide because we know where you are. We're coming to minister to you, and we're going to say, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, repent or die. Mm-hmm. And you're going to have a choice. Join us or run and hide. In the day of the Lord, in the book of Isaiah, he said he's going to come and all the ones hiding in the rocks, you ain't going to be able to get away from that judgment. That's what's coming, people. And we're telling y'all that right now. See? Was their children remember their altars and their groves and the green trees upon a high hill? Yeah, they didn't go right there. All this whoredom going on. On my mountain in the bell, I will give their subsistence and their treasures to the spoil. What are we today? A spoil nation. Our brothers and sisters. That's why the black woman is in a white man's arms. Y'all remember this in slavery? How many of y'all remember Ken Norton and those movies back in the 70s? Y'all remember this? So how do you think the black woman got out of our hands and turned into a whore? You know why? This is what happened to us. Auction box, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And prostitutes, they made you into a whore. They used to turn you around on the auction block and turn you to bend over, and the biggest butt black woman was bought by the slave master. And you know what they did to y'all when they took down them damn barns? You got raped. Then he told you to shake your ass. That's why these sisters shaking their ass now, don't they? You got telling you the truth, what they did. Look at Ken Norton. Big muscular brother back then. Put him on an auction block. This funky, dirty, 30-foot, harsh-ass Edomite woman on this movie. went over there on national TV and went in his draw. See, the 70s was wild. We lived in the 70s. And pulled his rod out on TV to see how big it was. You know where she was going to put it, right? Right in her funky ass. Just what they did to us, according to Joel chapter 3. And they turned the black man into a faggot, and they hung your asses on trees, then they stuck you in a damn church and put Caesar Borgia on the wall and told you, be a good nigga and pray, nigga. Okay? This is what they did to us. And then here it is, 2023, the black woman is all alone with a house full of kids. Slavery back then, captivity still as it is this day. This is where we are, people. And we want to get the hell out of here. And y'all don't want to get out of here. So the Most High said, what? Verse 4. And thou, even thyself, thou shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee. What's the heritage of the Israelites? Everybody that comes to this class, you know what it is. The laws of life. The statutes and the covenant of our heritage being Israel. Mashasha, our king. That's our heritage. Wearing the garments, wearing the fringes, wearing the border of blue, wearing the ancient garments, putting them on. This is what we're supposed to be walking around in this damn time, in our faith. And you sisters, wrap your head up, take them damn dreads out your hair, stop being a whore, and get you a husband, and have some beautiful Israelite babies. That's how you build a nation. And get all them damn white people and them damn Moabites and all the rest of them Hamites out of here. We want our nation back and our heritage back. So we lost it. See what it says here? And I will cause thee to serve thine enemies in a land which thou knowest not. For you have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever. Now, we don't show you that, right? Kwanzaa. This is one of the whoredom religions set up by this Negro right here. See this Negro right here? Maulanin Karinga. What kind of name is that? This brother here, Kwanzaa, is an annual celebration of African Americans. December 26th to January 1st, culminating in a communal feast called Kawamu, usually as the sixth day, and was created by an activist, Mulanin Kawaga, based on African harvest festival traditions. This is where this garbage came from this brother right here. He invented this thing called Kwanzaa. You see them black candles and red candles? You still have one of these. What is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The menorah is in the Bible. This is not in the Bible. Kwanzaa was invented by the civil rights activists right here. The leaders of our people calls us to earth. And this brother invented this thing and brought it to the Negroes based off the children of Ham's festival days and harvest, when we're supposed to be going by Leviticus chapter 23. So what are these Negroes? They ain't content. And this is the brother right here, the civil rights activist that deceived millions of our people with Kwanzaa. See what it says here? From the various parts of West and Southeast Africa. What were we doing in the land of Ham at that time? We were in a diaspora from the land of Jerusalem, and we went down into the land of Ham, and off this coast of what you call the Middle Passage, this is where the Israelites ended up at, and you were sold to bondmen and bondwomen, according to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15 to 68. And we came from these areas where the Hamitic nations were already set up, from a place called Fort of Judah, from the land of Jerusalem. And then when we got here, these civil rights activists, after the emancipation, decided to make a religion called Kwanzaa. See what it says here? Kwanzaa was first celebrated in 1966. Remember 1966? What was going on back then? The civil rights struggle. I was born in 1963. So I was born in the middle of all this hell in my life. And as little kids, our generation saw all these Negroes marching in the street, getting their heads busted open by the cops, living in the damn ghetto. And we said, what the hell's wrong with us? Then the elders of Israel came to us with the Bible. And they said, you are the real Jews. And you broke the Most High laws, commandments, and statutes. That's why all this stuff is happening to us. And through that, we escaped with the knowledge of the Most High. And the rest of our people are still following Kwanzaa. This is one of the whoredoms that you better not be dealing with. Because the Most High gave us high holy days, Kodash Yawam, according to the law. This brother makes up this Kwanzaa stuff. American Malunga Karenge created Kwanzaa in 1966 during the aftermath of the Watts riots as a specially African-American holiday. Karenge said the goal was to give blacks an alternative to the existing holiday of Christmas. What's the existing alternative for us now? To turn back to our nation and creator, Yahweh. This brother is a false prophet. Let's go to Hosea 9 and 1 for our last scripture for this evening. Hosea 9 and 1 says this. See, Israel got a zeal, but they ain't got no knowledge. So making up Kwanzaa is not going to save our people out of this damn hellhole of America. Rejoice not, O Israel, for joy, as other people. See, in this setup right here, we ain't got nothing to celebrate. No Christmas, no New Year's, no Halloween, no Kwanzaa. That's man-made. For thou is going a horn from your power. This is what the people's problem is. We must return to Yahweh, for Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Keep the commandments, immerse the righteous acts in the land of drawing waters. Believe in Yahweh Shai to be righteous. Keep the commandments, the knowledge of sin, and wait for Yahweh's return and his son to get us out of this captivity. And this is not what these brothers are teaching our people. Why? Because they're false prophets. The God is going to horn from your body. Thou hast love and reward upon every corn floor. The floor and the wine press shall not feed them, and the new wine shall fail in her. So what they invented and gave you in Kwanzaa is going to fail you. Because that's one of the whoredoms we had to show you tonight. Not to be getting involved in. See what it says here? And they shall not dwell in the Lord's land, but Ephraim shall return to Egypt, and they shall what? Eat unclean things in Assyria. This is where you're at right now. Guys eating pork, you'll swallow down religion. The Ephraimites, the Negroes, the Puerto Ricans, and so-called North American Indians, all the 12 tribes, Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, you'll swallow down this garbage. So what time is it now for you people? It's time for you to seek the Lord. In Hosea chapter 10, verse 12, it's time for you to repent, according to Acts chapter 3, verse 19. It's time for you to return, according to Mark chapter 1, verse 14 and 15, and repent and believe in the gospel. For the day of Yahweh Bashar is at hand, and he says, and the kingdom of heaven is at hand. So we must return and acknowledge and repent and keep the Father's commandments and the faith of his Son. This is a whole duty of the Israelite man. So brothers and sisters who have heard this message tonight, this has been part two of the African American movement, Kwanzaa. So brothers and sisters who have heard this message, we are say unto you, Shalom, Ra'a'alallah, means peace be unto you. In the name of Yahweh, Bahashem, Mashasha, and look up, brothers, for your redemption. For now, Shalom.